psychology hacks you need to know. If you want to make someone uncomfortable, look at their forehead while you're talking to them. If you want somebody to open up to you more, ask them a question, and if they only partially answer it, keep eye contact and stay silent. It will pressure them to talk more. If you want to be more persuasive, try and lose the words I think and I believe. When someone is touched on their shoulder or their knees, it creates a stronger emotional and physical bond with the person touching them. Chewing gum can help you when you're nervous because your brain thinks, well, I'm eating, I must not be in danger. If you walk up to a group of people and they turn their feet towards you, you are welcome. If they have their feet turned away from you, even if their body and head is turned towards you, they are uncomfortable with you walking up. Subtly nodding when someone is talking to you indicates to that person that you are genuinely interested in what they have to say and they're gonna like you more. Follow for more.
I don't relate to you, no, cause I never treat me this shitty.
Powerful psychological hack to get into someone's head and make them crave you. This is extremely powerful and will have the other person thinking about you nonstop, so be advised. This technique is called tactical anticipation. This can be done in several ways. One way is texting the person their name right before you go to sleep and then not responding till the morning. Another way is texting them, we need to talk or I have something to tell you, and then not responding for hours. The key is leaving enough space for them to imagine what you have to say. This achieves two objectives. It will create an open loop in their mind, which they'll crave to fill, and it also gets them to imagine about you. We fall in love through our imagination, so when you finally respond, their body will surge with dopamine, which they'll attribute to being attracted to you.
Answer the phone, Harry, you're no good alone. Why are you sitting at home on the floor? What kind of pills are you on? Ringing the bell. And nobody's coming to help. Your daddy lives by himself. He just wants to know that you're well. Oh, oh, in this world.
Don't please.
I want you out in the pouring rain. I want you down on your knees, praying to God that I feel the same. I'm right here, baby, so please.
Hold me up, tie me down, 'cause I never wanna.
Psychological tricks to mess with someone's head, part 1. Let's say that you are talking to someone. If you interrupt them and say walk with me in a busy tone and start walking away, they will start walking with you and continue the conversation. Now you can lead them really anywhere you want. Immediately after your friend looks at the time, ask them if they know what time is it. Chances are that they will have to look at the time again. Look distractedly on someone's nose or some other part of their face, and then scratch the same part of your own face. They will get confused and probably think that they have something on them and start scratching as well.
What are some useful psychological facts or tricks one should know? When listing things to someone, they are most likely to remember the first and last items in the list. This can be used when giving someone options and you would rather them choose certain ones without being too obvious if the items on the list aren't particularly out of place. Give kids a choice when trying to get them to do something. Would you like broccoli or carrots with lunch? When trying to get them to eat. Do you want mom or dad to tuck you in? When trying to get them to go to bed. It's not 100% by any means, but giving them the power of choice helps them feel in control and less likely to freak out. It might work with adults too, TBH. I just use it with my niece and things go so much smoother. When you ask someone for something, smile a little and nod your head almost imperceptibly. I almost always get what I'm asking for when I do this. Feels like a Jedi mind trick. I think people just like making someone happy and don't want to ruin the moment. I heard this the other day. Apparently, if you pick a word someone is using and smile each time they say that particular word, they will start to say the word more often. For example, someone is talking about dogs, and if you smile when they say dog, then they'll say dog more often. Someone is holding something you want? Get into a conversation with them, while listening to them talk, just put your hand out, smile and nod. they will most likely give it to you and totally forget.
Did you know that being too attracted to someone is actually very unhealthy? That sounds crazy, right? But Dr. Seth Meyers makes a great point, because the same part of your brain that gets activated during addiction can get activated when you're too into someone. It feels like an addiction. He also states that people who have trauma histories were neglected by their parents, had an absent mother or father, now has a void, which is where the love was supposed to be. So guess who they're gonna hope one day will fill that void for them? Yep, that significant other. So if you are jumping all in and they are consuming you, you may be filling a void.
But you don't, just don't say it's love. And no, it ain't sweet.
There are times when I will leave.
I can keep a secret, kid.
Yeah.
But my mind on your body and your body on my mind.
One of the most powerful psychology hacks to detect if someone is lying to you. Just a warning, getting good at detecting this will turn you into a human lie detector, so be advised. This is called the Pinocchio effect. When someone is telling you something and it doesn't feel quite right, observe their hands. The act of betrayal often causes an increase in temperature around the nose and the eye region as the blood vessels contract. The liar will often rub their eyes or nose as they're deceiving you because it gets itchy. That act paired with your intuitive gut feeling is a powerful giveaway.
Here's a psychological trick that you cannot live without. This is insanely powerful, and it goes like this. If you are anxious, if you are nervous, if you have an uncomfortable feeling in your body, and you do what I did, you splash cold water into your face, or you dip your face into cold water. This will activate something very ancient in you called the diving reflex. And the diving reflex has this function that it immediately lowers your heart rate and removes that feeling of anxiety in your body. And it goes immediately. Did I say that? This is so powerful. Share it, use it your entire life. It's incredible. Wow! I want more! We're so cold, Marcus.
It is the only thing that makes us feel alive.
Psychological facts that explain why we are the way we are. PT 28. People who swear a lot tend to be more loyal, upfront, and honest with friends.